Pinkpop.
3FM.
Ja, dat zijn we zeker. Je hebt net Raccoon ook gehoord. Je waren er ook live met Don't Give Up The Fight. Wat een prachtig liedje. Zo enorm klein. Lastig om te brengen op een festival. Maar iedereen zwijgt compleet en staat te staren naar de mainstage. En wat ik dan het allerleuke vind, is terwijl ze staan te kijken naar de mainstage, is hier op dat moment Keen aan het soundcheck in de studio. Die zijn hier dus gewoon een liedje aan het spelen. Zijn een beetje het liedje aan het doornemen. Maar niemand heeft het door. Iedereen kijkt naar de mainstage. How was that, Tom? Seeing people, you were watching all those people. You were singing a hit of yours. And everybody was looking the other way.
That's something. We're very used to that, you know.
No, you're not. You're not. How are you doing, man?
We're great, yeah. I mean, what an incredible day.
It's incredible. For the Netherlands, well, in England, it's the same.
It is, yeah.
It's very special that this kind of weather, it's 3 days in a row.
It's lovely, isn't it? It makes a festival when the weather's like this, I think.
It sure does. Okay. I have to start with a little story. It was, I think, 2004. I met you for the very first time. I'm very sure you don't know anymore because it was at 3FM.
I remember it well.
Yeah, no. At the normal studio, and you were waiting for a DJ who was a little bit late for an interview, and I gave you some tea and coffee and all the band members, and we had a little chit-chat, and Somewhere Only We Know was just out, and you told me, well, if you like that song, because I said, I like that song, you said, you have to check our album, Hopes and Fears. I'm sure you like it. And you gave me the album, and you said, okay, well, let me know what you think about it. You smiled, because we will never meet again. Well, not in a few weeks. But today, 8 years later, I'd like to thank you for that album, and I really, really liked it.
You enjoyed it, did you?
I enjoyed it, yes.
Good. Well, so did a lot of other people, which was nice.
Yeah. It was stuck in my car for a long period of time.
Oh, dear. I hope you got it out.
Well, with some extra material, some tools. Yeah, I got it out of my car.
Yeah.
Okay, well, back in Holland here, 8 years later, your new album, Strangeland, is just out.
I know.
And listened to it a few times.
You like it?
I like it. I do like it.
It's
kind of the Hopes and Fears reborn, I think. I really like what's on it. It's 2012 wise.
Yeah.
But I like it. I like the sound.
We're very proud of it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I was talking to Gauthier a few weeks ago, and he told me that he wrote the song Somebody That I Used to Know, and it took him about 1 year to write that song.
Yeah.
It was a big struggle to make the song just right. What was it with this album? Was it just did it just fit, or did it took some time to finish some songs?
Well, Tim does the songwriting in the band, and he's not got a microphone on for those listening. But we leave him to do his own thing. And one of the things we felt with this album was that we really wanted to really prepare and have a long time to make it. And so I think that it was about 3 years in the making in terms of the writing and recording and producing. So it was really a labor of love.
Okay, but Tim, I'm looking at Tim now. Were there some pain in the ass songs on the album?
Sorry, say that again.
Were there some pain in the ass songs on that album when you have to, I have to finish it, but I don't know how, it's just a struggle to make it finish?
Yeah, it's sometimes, it's funny, like some of the, like Silence by the Night, which was the first single, took about 10 minutes to write.
Yeah, it
was. But then, you know, there are songs on there that took about 5 years or something, so it's, yeah, sometimes they're just really hard, like lyrics are hard to do.
Okay.
But, you know, it's a great feeling when you finish one and you know it's good, so
it's all together. Wow. Okay. The next thing is Sovereign Light Cafe. It's your hometown cafe, is it right? Where you grew up.
Yes, it is. Yeah, well, it's kind of, we all grew up on the coast, south of England, and it was a place, well, particularly Tim and Richard used to go there to try and find girls, and they used to get their skinny white bodies out in the sunshine. And but the thing about Bexhill, which is where this place is, the Sovereign Light Cafe, is it's really just full of lots of 80-year-old people. So I don't know quite what they were looking for, but we remember it well. It was the song is kind of about looking back to the time when you first had that very simple dream of wanting to be a band and wanting to be a success and wanting to kind of get out of the small town that you're in. So
okay.
It seemed appropriate.
Okay, we talked about Silence by the Night. We talked about Sovereign Light Cafe, and you're going to play both songs now.
We are. We love live to. Yeah, we're going to play Silenced by the Night first. I think.
A very acoustic setting. I'd like to have a big round of applause for Keith.
Thank you. Got the radio on, got the wheels in motion. We were silenced by the night, but you and you won't go far.
Wow. Wow. Silence by the Night en een nieuwe single, Suffering Light Café. Dat was Keen gewoon live hier in de studio. 3 microfoontjes, 4 topmuzikanten en na 7 minuten fantastisch goede muziek. It was wonderful, man.
Thank you very much for having us.
Wow.
It was a pleasure.
Enjoy your performance this night.
We can't wait.
Oh, man.
We can't wait.
Okay, and see you in about 8 years.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Leuke band.
Vette sfeer.
Ja, echt superleuk.
Ongelooflijk, Pinkpop 2012, wat is het nu al ongelooflijk vet. Zometeen, als jij hebt ge-sms'd voor een very important phone call met de Asteroids Galaxy Tour, bellen met je idool, nou dan moet je in de buurt van je telefoon blijven, want zometeen gaan we dat doen.
Pinkpop 2012.
Bart Arends.
3FM.